Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to take apart your Volkswagen key. If you just want to replace the battery, please see my other video for just that. In this video I'm going to take the key apart. Some reasons you might want to do this are to replace the metal switchblade, if you just want to replace the case or this metal key ring, or if you want to replace the immobilizer chip. Now before you buy a used key or decide to replace the immobilizer chip, please see the immobilizer pages on my website for details on how the system works. From around 1999 to around 2009, Volkswagen used this style, which has a blue metalized logo. From around 2009, 2010, and later, Volkswagen started using this one with a smaller black rubberized logo. If you have this style of key, first you have to pop the Volkswagen badge off. I've already prepared a key. This screw is just to the left of center, and there's a small gap where you can insert a pry. Now, once you remove the badge, you can undo the screw that's holding the two halves together, then insert a pry here, and this key splits open just like that. Now the side opposite the buttons, there's a small seam where you can insert a small pry to pry the two halves apart. If you want to replace the remote half, there you go. Now this key half is held together with that one screw. Now that that screw is removed, you can just gently pry these two halves apart. Now there's a spring that controls the switchblade, the key switchblade, so just open it carefully, just like that. Note that when I release the tension on this upper part rotates clockwise. Here's the metal switchblade, if you ever need to replace that. This half is just plastic, but this half contains the immobilizer chip. Inside the upper half, you can see this little glass pill. This is the RFID chip that talks to your immobilizer system. If for whatever reason you want to swap the guts of your remote, like the remote half and the switchblade, to a new key, you also have to switch this little pill over so that the immobilizer system is not tripped. This can be replaced separately in this style of key. Now, when you go to reinstall the switchblade, you have to get the spring motion right. So I suggest putting this on and then turning this counterclockwise. Then pressing the two halves together, just like that. Otherwise, if you don't get it right, your switchblade will always stay in the closed position when you press this button. And installation is the reverse of removal. If you have this style of key, Volkswagen really didn't want you taking it apart. The reason why is because they locked it. First, pry the battery cover off, and then look at your key. I actually had to destroy this key to figure out how to get it open, but now that I do, I'm going to share it with you. Normally, there's a metal pin right here that locks the two halves of this case together. Now, you would either have to drill this pin out, or drill two holes here and here to weaken the plastic that's clamping this down. Once you can get this pin out or have weakened the plastic to break the case to get it open, then you can pry open like this. Here you can see another metal pin that acts as a hinge. I'm going to pry open just like this. And again, this key is damaged because I had to figure out how to get this thing open. And it opens just like that. Here you can see the metal pin and the plastic that kind of holds it in. Here's the insides of the new style key. I'm pretty sure this is the RFID chip, and this is now non-replaceable. Not only is it glued and soldered in, but I'm not even sure where you could buy these. In addition, after around 2007, Volkswagen started encrypting their immobilizer chips, and there are currently no aftermarket tools to reprogram them anyways. However, if as long as you have a working good portion this board, you can replace the switchblade, the keyring, or the case if it's broken, and just put it into a replacement case and swap this chip over. Now, I noticed that the eBay replacement cases aren't exactly the same as the OEM style case, but it looks like this chip will fit into the replacement cases. Luckily, the replacement cases are held together with a screw, so you just have to pop the internals and the switchblade over to your new case. Now, if for whatever reason you wanted to reuse your original case, but you drilled out this pin or drilled out two holes to weaken the plastic to get the pin out, you may be wondering, how am I going to get the original case to stick? Well, there are some clips along the edges. So as you can see, even with the case broken, it's still pretty decent. If you just add a touch of glue, I'm sure it would stick together. And that's about it. Thank you for watching.